All right, and here we go. CLT math practice test number one. Question number 95. We have two rectangles are similar. Which of the following must be true? Okay, so two rectangles are similar. So we could have a rectangle like this and a rectangle like this. Oopsie, sorry, my rectangles might be a little bit made out of jello. Yeah, they should be straight edges for a rectangle, right? So I got them like a mom and a baby rectangle. They don't have to look like this because similar rectangles could also be equivalent rectangles. Every square is a rectangle. You could have two equivalent squares that are exactly the same. Both rectangles are square. Could be true, but not must be true. The interior angles of each rectangle add up to 360 degrees. 90 times 4 is 360. That must always be true of every rectangle. One of the rectangles has a larger area than the other rectangle. If we have a mom and a baby rectangle, that could be true. Or D, the lengths of the diagonals of the rectangles are equivalent. Could be true if they're exactly the same, or could not be true if our similar rectangles are different sizes. Could. So we found our must answer was B. Number 96, a math teacher has a no homework on Friday policy. Yesterday, Chase came home with homework. Assuming that the math teacher kept to her policy, what must be true about today? So, yesterday, Chase came home with homework. So, could today be Tuesday? Yeah, today could be Tuesday. Or Wednesday, or Thursday, or Friday. So, A and B are equally a possibility, but they are not a must. So they're not our answer. Today is not Friday. Well, we said maybe it is Friday. Today is not Saturday, right? Because if today was Saturday, then yesterday would have been Friday, and Chase would not have had homework on Friday because the math teacher's policy is no homework on Fridays, and teachers are, to the very best of their capabilities, promise keepers when it comes to a no homework on Friday policy. So D is our correct answer. Rolling along to number 97. A class of 12 is divided into teams of two. How many different two-person combinations are possible in this group of 12? So, right, so like in elementary school where a teacher was like, every student has a number and I'm going to pull a stick and number whoever gets to be line leader for the day, things like that, right? Everybody's got, let's give everybody a number like that. So student number 12 could be with student number 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, or 1. So student 12 has 11 possibilities of who to buddy up with. Looking at student number 11, they've already been buddied with 12, so they're going to start buddying with a number 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So student 11 has 10 possible buddies to buddy up with in the line. So we're going to continue going down the line, right? Student 12, student 11, student 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now moving on to student 10. Look at the pattern, right? We got 11. We got 10. What comes next? We got 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And student number 1, it's not that they don't get a buddy, right? But there's just no new combinations for us to write down with them. Student number 1, they've already, you see at the bottom, if we continued writing it all out, student number 1 would have been on everybody's list. So there's nothing new there. So now we're going to take these numbers and count up how many different two-person combinations are possible, right? So 11 plus 10 plus 9. 11, 10 plus 9, and 8, 7, 6, plus 8, 7, 6, plus 5, 4, 3, plus 2, 1, 0. I'm going to get all of these, and then I'm going to add them all up. 11 plus 10 plus 9 should be 30. 8 plus 7, 15 plus 6, 21. 5 plus 4 is 9 plus 3, 12. 2 plus 1 is 3 plus 0, 3. Now I got 30, 21, 12, and 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that is our answer. We've got 66 possible combinations. And I'm going to keep moving to question number 98. For biology class, you are calculating how much growth medium it will take to refill the class set of agar plates. Each agar plate is a cylinder. A cylinder with a base that has a radius of 5 centimeters. And a height is 2 centimeters. There are 30 agar plates in the class set. So whatever we get is times 30 of them. To refill them, you need enough growth medium to fill each plate halfway. So I'm only going to fill it halfway. I'm not filling it to the height of 2. So I'm actually going to erase that 2 and put a 1. 2 divided by 2 is 1. Half of 2 is 1, right? I'm only filling it halfway. How much growth medium in centimeters cubed will you need? So, right, how much can hold in the container? That is what formula. That is our volume formula. And volume of a cylinder, if you take a look with me really quickly on our reference sheet, volume of a cylinder is not here. What we do have here on our reference sheet is area of a circle is pi r squared. So I'm going to take this little piece of information. Area of a circle is pi r squared, right? And I'm going to look at my cylinder and I see that it does have a circle as the base. So volume of a cylinder is our pi r squared, the area of the base, times its height. So I'm taking the formula that they gave us, and to go from area, which is two-dimensional, which is a circle, to make it three-dimensional, to make it the volume of a cylinder, volume of a 3D figure, I just take that area of the base and multiply it by the height, because the height goes straight up. And now I've got my formula for volume of a cylinder. And the question, how much growth medium in centimeters cubed will you need to fill up our class set of 30 agar plates? So I got, now that I have my volume of a cylinder formula, I'm going to take the volume of what we need for this question formula and take this volume of a cylinder and then multiply it by 30, because we've got 30 plates. And now my height that we need is just 1. So I'm going to erase H and put a 1. Pi r squared, pi times radius squared. And our radius of our circle is 5. So I'm going to fill in a 5. And I'm going to get some multiplying, right? So I got pi times 5 squared. That's 25 times 1 is still 25. And now 25 times 30. I'm going to do a little math over here. 25 times 30. I'm going to do some fourth grade multiplication, if I can remember how to do this, right? Multiply everything times 0 in the ones place, and now multiply the tens place. 3 times 5 is 15, and then multiply my tens by my tens. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 750. So all of this, when we multiply, is going to be 750, and then times pi. But in our answer choices, they didn't multiply times pi, so we don't have to take the next step and multiply our answer times 3.14 for pi, because we're done. And that's going to be it for this video, and I will see you on the next one, guys. I'm rooting for you. We got this.